My name is Lena, I'm from Germany, and 2.5 years ago, I decided to leave everything behind and move to Norway to live a life close to nature. Today, I want to share really honest my personal story with you, how and why all that happened. I lived in Hamburg since I was 14, and I lived there in the middle of the city for 7 years. These 7 years, I lived under constant inner tension and stress, always asking myself, what the hell is wrong with me? It's hard to describe. Imagine you just step out of the door. There are people, they're talking, maybe looking at you, maybe don't even notice you. Traffic is passing by, loud noises, blinking lights everywhere. Your chest tightens, you can't breathe, you get scared, your mind gets blurry, you feel completely paralyzed, and you just don't know why, because somehow nobody else seems to experience it the same way you do. I guess we are all afraid of being excluded, being the strange one. So I learned to pull myself together and act as normal as I could. But at some point, I started to get panic attacks in crowded places. I suddenly fainted in class or in the subway, and I felt more and more depressed. I didn't want to go out anymore at all. I was afraid of people, and sometimes even going to the supermarket became a real challenge. During the whole time, I hated myself so much, always telling me I'm just not trying hard enough and struggling with the feeling of not fitting in and not belonging somewhere. The first time I traveled to Norway was on a holiday to visit a friend. And the moment I stepped out of the plane, something happened. There was this cold wind in my face. I heard people talking in Norwegian, and suddenly I had this strong feeling of being home. I stayed at this beautiful place called Dream Valley with my now dear friend Tina and her 9 horses. A small farm surrounded by endless forests and mountains. I didn't even know it is possible to live like that. This simple life down to earth, together with the animals, touched something deep inside of me. And in the moment I was sitting in the plane back to Germany, I knew I had to come back. And that is what I did as often as I could. And all the time when I was sitting in my apartment in Hamburg, I was dreaming about the special sound of silence, the feeling of space, the clean, fresh air, the smell of the forests, and the tranquility of a freezing, deep, dark winter landscape. So right after I finished my studies, I packed my things again and traveled back to Dream Valley. I didn't have a plan, but already after 1 week, I suddenly woke up in the night and I knew I will not go back to Germany. Do you know these kind of decisions? When you just know, you don't have to analyze the pros and cons, will you do it, will you not, you just know. Since then, I stayed in Dream Valley for another year. Built myself a little home on wheels and traveled other areas of this beautiful country together with my 2 most loved beings. Last autumn, we ended up in a sweet little house in the Norwegian countryside. This is more I could ever wish for. Just us, together, sitting by the fire, living a simple life, not having much and not needing much. Just doing what we love and working really hard on bringing our next big dream into life. After such a long time, I finally feel I can slowly let go of this tension I was holding all the time and just breathe. I still don't know why I experience everything like that. I read all the books about hypersensitivity, therapeutic techniques, meditation, grounding strategies, and self-development. And I think it's great to keep improving and growing, but not out of a state of there is something wrong with me which I need to fix. I am not broken, and neither are you. We all have different struggles in life, things that maybe have hurt us or a pain that we are carrying. And we live in a society where things like that are not really liked to be seen, where being happy, motivated, successful and in the best case spiritual enlightened is almost the biggest status symbol. But life has both sides, and sometimes there is just darkness and we don't have an answer. And you know what? That is okay. We don't have to. So the biggest relief for me was to surrender, to accept that I feel how I feel and that the things are how they are. When we are stopped fighting or judging in either way, we can suddenly see everything out of a neutral perspective. And out of a neutral perspective, we are able to choose. We can choose to create ourselves a life that serves us. An environment where we feel safe and loved and where we can grow into our best version, whatever that means to you. And even if for you it's also not matching with any common idea of how that should look like. So when somebody asks me why I moved to Norway, I always tend to answer, well, I just like it here a lot. It's a beautiful country with all the nature, you know. But I guess I finally had to tell the real story. It was so much more than that. It was life-saving.